we're going to actually talk more about scale and size. So at the top, the width of the deltoid is small or narrow. And at the bottom here, at the knuckles of the hand, it's going to be larger or wider than the deltoid, right? I purposely made it the same width in the first two passes, meaning distance and structure. Where here, I'm going to really play up the width, right? Or the smallness of what's far away versus the largeness of what's closer to us, right? You can see already what's starting to happen, that the hand is becoming quite large, right? The hand is really large in comparison to the deltoid, and the fingers are going to get, you know, larger. Look how much larger they are in this drawing in comparison to the ghosted one on the left-hand side. Now let's take this guy, right? The far right drawing would have the most amount of, like, what I call pinch, right? It's like pinching to the shoulder. It's really wide close to us, and then small at the top and really large or wide at the bottom, right? And you can see I've just created those lines on the left and lines on the right to give me the sense of scale that I want. I can control that, you know, again, with those two simple lines. I've already set up what the structure of scale change will be, right? I'm still thinking about structure, you know, but there are those two lines by the elbow. That's the form lines that I've put down, right, for the tubularness, the roundness of the arm right there. Okay. And then I'm building in my mind, but at the same time, I'm keeping track of size, right? I'm trying to stay within the box that I gave myself, the constraints I gave myself when drawing now the fingers. So look at the difference, right? If you look at the hand I'm drawing now in comparison to the hand on the far left, right? That one on the far left is really far away. The one in the middle is coming up towards us, and the one on the right is basically pointing right at our face.